The new boots!
They got me my boots! The boots were stolen and they replaced them! Thank you!
Ready? One, two, three!
Get a camera that works!
We're celebrating Three Kings Day, and for me, you know, Three Kings is about giving. To us, that's cultural justice. It's really, I think, a responsibility for El Museo, and I want you to help us with this, to assume a larger role in representing the greater wealth, the greater cultural richness that the United States has with the Latino populations here. I'm glad that I see the mayor.
Sort of piggybacking off of that, the mayor is in the house, and I got to thank the mayor's office. Because of the mayor's office, my feature film, The Stockroom, will be promoted throughout the city, starting in May, at bus shelters, subway trains, and we're going to tell the people that the movie exists, and that it was shot here in El Barrio. So thank you, Mr. Mayor.
It's such an honor to be here. Feliz Dia de los Reyes a todos.
We are stronger because of all the people who make us up now. Brothers and sisters, isn't it interesting that some people, I'm certain, are proud of their immigrant roots maybe 75, 100, 150 years ago, but are very ready to kick the ladder away to ensure that no one new gets to come in, which makes no sense in the perspective of history. We either are great because we receive old people or we're not. We have to decide who we are as a nation. Luckily, in New York City, we have decided. We are proud of each and every strand that makes up this great city. We could not be the greatest city in the world without the Puerto Rican community, without the Dominican community, without the broader Latino community.
East Harlem is the center of the universe in terms of how to plan for the future. And this community is taking that responsibility very, very seriously. Other neighborhoods, other parts of the country are looking to see how you do it, and you're doing it well. That's a big, big responsibility, and I want to congratulate you, because that's also part of tradition and culture, is to have that kind of technology, technical assistance, and gravitas to make sure that it happens right. The other thing I want to say is, you're king and queen, oh my goodness, they understand young people. That guy, O'Farrell, he has more time that he has spent teaching young people about music and tradition than the entire city combined. So I want to thank Arturo for being a wonderful role model for young people.
Now, these are friends, these are family, these are people that you interact with on a daily basis. These are people that are movers and shakers and pioneers, people who are going to move us into a new future, a positive future. So please, give them a big round of applause. Yeah. And of course, it's in your program, so you don't have to memorize what I just said. So that's great. No laughing, Papoleto. All right. He's a good-looking guy, right? The guy in the corner there to the left? Good-looking guy, right? Handsome guy? Yeah, we'll talk about it in a second. Every year for the past 20 years, this individual has served as our king.
Emeritus.
Emeritus.
Aha.
I was going to say aha at the end to make it good. Aha. There we go. All right. King Emeritus. Joyfully leading the parade through the streets of El Barrio with his infectious and humorous spirit. And if you know Papoleto, this guy will cheer you up, make you happy. He's one of the greatest guys. By the way, he stars in my film, The Stockroom. All right, it wasn't just filming in El Barrio. It was asking folks who are in the neighborhood, and we had a great, fantastic time. The person I'm acknowledging is Jesus Papoleto Melendez. You're great, man. You're amazing, bro. I honor you, man. I humble myself to you, man. You're an amazing dude.
You too, bro.
Yeah, you're beautiful, bro. I love you. I love these guys, too, and I'm going to get to them in a second because each one of these guys, I mean, I look at them, my friend. These are a New York-born Puerto Rican award-winning poet, playwright, teacher, and activist. He began his career nearly 40 years ago as a poet facilitator in public schools, working at workshop programs in California and New York. I asked Papoleto to join me on stage for a special award. Come on down, my brother. Give this guy a big round of applause! And maybe, and Papa, maybe you want to say just some brief few words to the crowd.
Thank you, Victor. I loved working with him, very professional guy. And, you know, he's not up and coming, he's here.
That's right, baby.
And everybody, all the people on stage, I just want to say, you know, I love Three Kings Day because to me, like I was telling someone earlier, this is such a community event. It's probably the happiest day of the whole year, except for your birthday. And I think that to me, like everybody is baby Jesus. Everybody. Thanks.
So I'd first like to introduce to the crowd, this guy is a good friend, man. I know this guy for years. He's a talented actor. He is an ex-Marine police officer. This guy does amazing things for the community. He's a good friend. First King here is J.W. Cortez. J.W. Cortez is an award-winning actor, Marine combat veteran, singer, filmmaker, and philanthropist. He's wearing the Miguel de Cervantes costume. Yeah, you gotta show it off, man. You look great. When I saw you, I was like, ay, pero quien es papi king? I'd like to also welcome Sonia Manzano. Sonia Manzano is an actor and writer, best known for her role as Maria on Sesame Street, as well as her first novel, The Revolution of Evelyn Serrano, which was a puramente honored book. She is wearing the Anacaona costume. And she looks absolutely beautiful. And I'd like to welcome our third king, Arturo O'Farrill. Arturo O'Farrill is a musician, educator, world-renowned Grammy Award-winning pianist, composer, and educator. He is the creator of the Afro-Latin Jazz Orchestra. He is wearing the Arturo Schaumburg costume, and he looks fantastic.
So this is wonderful. I have to confess, the first time I actually was a bystander watching the parade was last year when it was really snowing. And the last icon in the parade was the Dia de los Muertos icon. And I just thought that was absolutely so appropriate. And it really gave me a sense of the community and how we embrace each other. So thank you for including me in this year's festivities.
I was born in Mexico and we celebrated Three Kings Day. And I suspect people in Peru celebrate Three Kings Day and people in Colombia and people throughout Latin America. And when I think of these things, I don't think of Peru, Colombia, Puerto Rico, Argentina. I think of mambo. Festejo, bomba, plena. I think about the music that unites all of us and it's international. It's internationally recognized and beloved. And so what we bring to the planet is like what the three kings bring, great joy and great gifts for all. Thank you for this incredible honor.
At this time, I'd like to present each of our honorary madrinas with a special recognition. Thank you for being such a positive role models, especially for the youth in our communities. Thank you. And this woman here who I'm going to acknowledge, she opened up her doors at the New Yorican Poets Cafe when I was starting out as an artist, and that was Carmen M. Pietri Diaz, former executive director of the New Yorican Poets Cafe. Carmen Pietri passed away on July 17, 2015. She was also co-administrator of the Pedro Pietri Benefit Fund. Carmen sat on the boards of various cultural organizations, including the Clemente Soto Velez Cultural Center, was president and CEO of Zero Budget Productions, and program director at Two Leaf Press. Joining us today is her brother Joe Pietri and her husband Samuel Diaz. Please give them a big round of applause.
Terrible nostalgia. Pude volver al San Juan de ver pedacito